It was 14 years ago in war-torn Afghanistan when Army veteran Rafael Teixeira first hurt his back. In September, an unexpected flare-up sent him to the Haley VA Medical Center ER. But he tells us a half dozen injections did not relieve the pain, leaving this 36-year-old bedridden most of the time.
I was considering killing myself every day that I was in pain, every single day that I was in pain.
The pain was that bad?
It was that bad.
He was finally approved in January to go outside the VA under the 2019 Mission Act.
But you're talking about a five-month wait for something that I desperately need, and that's completely unreasonable. There should be other options.
I want to quickly share with you some of the issues I have when it comes to dealing with the VA. Yes, I'm talking about Veterans Affairs, the same system that supposedly is dedicated to the best interest of aiding and assisting its military veterans, many military veterans such as myself. In certain regards, the VA has been very resourceful for me. I cannot deny its impact in that regard. However, I must say this, when it comes to certain stipulations, the VA tries its best to place on veterans, I have a huge issue with that. And the reason why I have an issue with that is because to me, it seems as though veterans have no other option other than just to acquiesce to the demands of the VA itself, which in my personal opinion is fucking bullshit. Now, I recently go to the VA to request a physical examination, and I don't even think I can really call that a physical examination. Checking my blood pressure, checking my breathing, checking to see if I can walk straight. That's not a fucking physical examination. But I digress. There are three things with the VA that I just have an issue with, and it pertains to this incessant mandate for medication, this incessant mandate to take the COVID shot, and mental health issues that for some reason when you put in a request to try to seek consultation for it, they'll give you that initial meeting, but they don't follow up on it. Now in regards to medication, if you truly need to take medication, go right ahead and take it. But my biggest problem when it comes to medication, it seems as though that's the only thing the VA mandates for veterans and patients to take. Have a headache, medication. Have a knee problem, medication. Back hurting, medication. Sinus issue, medication. Heart problem, medication. Et cetera, medication. You don't even have to look in the neighborhood to find out who the big drug dealers are. The biggest drug dealers are these pharmaceutical companies. And the biggest suppliers of these drug dealers, in my opinion, is the VA. I go get checked out and seen. And the main thing the nurses and the doctors kept asking me was about medication. I go in and say, listen, I'm dealing with a dose of insomnia that I'm having nightmares.
Oh, that's prescribed you melatonin so that you don't be able to sleep.
Then when I tell them I've taken that before, it doesn't work.
Oh, I'm sorry. Let's give you a higher dose of the medication.
Many of these nurses and doctors think that you are a zombie and truly believe that you're dumb simply because you don't believe in just automatically taking medication. I've had allergic reactions to medications before, so why do I feel the need to just constantly go for every issue and just being prescribed medication? Medication is not the end-all to be-all to solve anything. In fact, medication doesn't heal anything. Medication only suppresses the pain or the ailment that you're currently dealing with. And you're going to tell me that I'm just supposed to automatically just take medication simply because you prescribe it? What happens when I don't take it? Oh, now they want to write that down in their report and saying that you're refusing the medication. That's why you're not getting any better. I call bullshit. To me, it seems like the VA really doesn't want to fully address the issues many veterans face. And if medication is the only prescribed form of aid that you can administer to veterans, what is the point of veterans going to the VA to get treated for in the first place? After all, you're supposed to be taking care of lives of your veterans. Is America such a contradiction to, well, they tell you they thank you for your service, while at the same time, using you as a guinea pig to experiment on various forms of medication? Trust me, I've seen it countless times when I go into the VA. That is why I'm very cautious when I'm being prescribed medication. And I get into it with a lot of doctors in regards to medication simply because I don't take it all the time. If it's something that has an adverse effect to my health and my body, I'm not taking that shit. And then you get mad when I say, no, I have patient advocate rights. I'm going to utilize my rights whether you like it or not. So that's one of the biggest issues I have with the VA. It's this automatically pushing medication to solve everything. If these doctors did their job, then maybe the problems that many veterans coming to the VA are dealing with, it will be solved much more efficiently.
Because this is about veterans' health care and about making sure they get the health care that they need in a timely manner.
Selnick is now with Concerned Veterans for America and says one issue is a lack of transparency about wait times. VA is still posting data based on the old law that allowed for a longer wait time before community care kicked in, and the calendar didn't start on the day the veteran requested the appointment.
I have internal people inside the VA telling me that there's a concentrated effort to deny veterans and community care because, frankly, too many veterans aren't.
Another problem I have with the VA is the COVID-19 vaccine. I get it. You have to ask that question when you're going to the VA. That's mandated by federal law. I get it. But let me check this out. If I tell you that, no, I haven't taken the vaccine. No, I do not intend on taking the vaccine. Why do you feel the need to continue to persuade me or pressure me into taking a shot? And then you get mad when I say, no, I haven't taken the flu shot. I'm telling you, this is what happened to me recently at the VA. I go in, the nurse says,
have you taken a flu shot?
No, I haven't taken a flu shot in 14 years. From 2002 to 2007, that 5-year stretch when I was in the Army, I caught 3 different allergic reactions through the flu shots alone. So I refuse to take a flu shot because I've learned how to use an alternative resource in order to counteract any flu or common cold that I may be experiencing at the moment. You know, alternative measures such as eating fresh fruits and vegetables more, drinking alkaline water, sea moss, elderberries, ginger, spice, all that good stuff. That is good and productive for the body, and taking more fiber, putting more potassium, putting more protein, laying off of the sugar, and all that. Why do I need a shot to help me from getting sick? That don't effectively work on everybody. And as far as this COVID-19, who are you to tell me to get a fucking shot? And the crazy thing about this visit was, this nurse had the nerve to try to say something smart out of her mouth.
Well, I know a couple of people that died that wasn't vaccinated.
Well, guess what? I know a couple of people that got it and still died. So don't try to convince me to take something that I myself have been tested for, and I've been tested negative each and every time. So if I don't have it, why the fuck do I feel the need to take something that I don't even have? Now, I get it. This country wants to get back into its regular motion again, but guess what? When you shut an entire country and the world down, and you're doing it to reset the way that this world is operating and ran, you don't go back to being normal. So it's like many of these people that work within the VA are brainwashed into just going along to get along. Again, I do not have to take it if I don't want to. Who are you to try to convince me to do it? Who are you to pressure me saying, oh,
I feel bad for you.
Fuck you, I feel bad for you. That's the major problem with the VA. Many of these people do not work in the best interest of veterans. They work to maintain their jobs and to get a paycheck. If you're working at a government agency that is designed to help and aid the best interest of veterans, and if you're only there for a paycheck, you may need to look for another occupation. Because I got rights, and I'm going to utilize and exercise it, and I don't care how you feel about it. So again, don't pressure me into doing something that I ain't come there to do it. If I want to take the vaccine, I'll come to you. But if I don't want to take it, don't try to make me or try to pressure me into doing otherwise. Because I'm a fighter, I'll fight back, and I refuse to take it, no matter if you strap me down or not.
They generate forms which had no bearing on the claims.
And that's why he said it all gave him a pain in his stomach.
It wasn't uncommon to see somebody sending in forms for a year, year and a half. And when I call these people, I find out, yeah, my car's already been taken. My home is going into foreclosure. And I lost my spouse 6 months ago. It's like, and we're playing around with
it. Now, as far as the PTSD clinic here in North Chicago, I have no issue with that. When I went through the PTSD clinic 7 years ago, it served the best interest of what I needed at the time. I was able to take advantage of the various resources that the PTSD clinic was able to provide for. So I have no issue with that. My thing with mental health is this. If I request for counseling or consultation or to set up some type of treatment, you only give me a consultation, but then don't follow up on it, and then 3-4 months later, you get mad and upset, and then try to blame me that I didn't follow up on it, when in fact I did, because I kept calling your asses back and kept saying, hey, what's going on with the consultation, and what did the mental health provider say in regards to my issues? How you get mad at me for doing what I'm supposed to do, but you ain't following up and doing your job? Once again, many of these people work in the VA to try to just advance, to elevate themselves to different positions or different hospitals, or they just doing it just to get paid. I ain't mad at you if you're getting your paper, but don't say that you care about veterans when we know for a fact you're just doing it to get a paycheck and you're just moving people right along. That's not treating no veterans' mental health. If it was your family member, how would you feel if you went to a private or a public hospital and doctors treated your family members that had mental health issues like shit? You wouldn't like it at all. So who are you to tell many veterans who are undergoing many mental health issues that their primary issues don't matter? To me, it seems as though you're using mental health as a plausible deniability. What I mean by that is this. You're trying to cover up into insisting that mental health is the major root of you wanting to help veterans, while at the same time only really suggesting medication in relation to getting hope. I take great issue with that. No veteran should ever be denied mental health service simply because you don't want to do your job into ensuring that the veteran is placed in the proper hands that is accessible for that veteran to treat their issues. If you can't do it at this mental health facility, assign that veteran to another VA facility so that he or she may be able to get the proper help and treatment that they need. I shouldn't be having to wait 3-4 months and then bring it back up to my primary care provider and say, yeah, you know, I'm having insomnia, I'm having sleep issues, I'm having nightmares. But I remember, you know, bringing that up 3-4 months ago. But when I did the consultation, I ain't hear nothing back from them. That makes my primary care provider look bad, and that makes the facility itself look worse, because you're denying a veteran his true proper service that they desperately need. So in conclusion, the VA services great benefits for those who really need it. Like I said, you know, some of the benefits with the VA, it really helps. I remember, you know, I had back issues about 5 years ago. They recommended that I go to acupuncture. The acupuncture that was serviced to me outside of the VA facility, it worked a great deal. However, this constant push for medication, this constantly persuading and pressuring you to take the vax, and then neglecting veterans of its true services in regards to mental health, those are lingering issues that the VA need to really fix. I'm tired of media, and I'm tired of this government saying that it really cares about veterans, when in reality, you really use the majority of American veterans as if they're guinea pigs. I'm a fucking human being. I should not be treated as if I'm a project or an experiment. I'm neither of the above. I'm a man that has problems just like the next man does. And I'm a veteran who has the right to go to the VA to get my needs addressed. So if you can't do it for me, guess what? I won't be coming back there. And if you are serious about addressing the problem, do it. Otherwise, you're going to get more and more veterans that are going to refuse to come to the VA. And then when more and more veterans are committing suicide, and I don't want to hear shit from CNN, MSNBC, and Fox News making reports about the suicide rate amongst veterans are going up. Want to know one reason why? It's because the VA is neglecting its proper duty and to properly and rightfully treating veterans the way that they supposed to. To all my soldiers worldwide, salute. To the VA, get on your goddamn job. But otherwise, stop saying you care for veterans when we know in reality you're not. I'm out.
Keith Brown is one of far too many veterans who died waiting for benefits.
He was upset to the max.
1 month after he was diagnosed with terminal cancer, the VA denied his claim as his life on this earth ticked away. And then after a lot of back and forth, approved his benefits 6 days before he died.
There's got to be something better. Because if they wait long enough and that veteran dies, they are under no obligation to make a determination at all or to pay back pay.